This is part 4 of the basics of Radius Max CAD series, where I explain every UI button regarding CAD. In previous videos, we went through the CAD parent triangle, hubs and limbs. Check those videos before this one if you haven't already. Now let's take a look at spine, neck and head. Hey fellow animators, I'm Miloš Čech. So here, again we have a CAD parent with pelvis created. Let's add a spine to it and select one of its bones. Maybe just add the legs as well, just to make it more clear how the actual character would look like. Okay, so most of these parameters that are here we have already discussed, name, number of bones, dimensions and so on. However, we have this important spine control setting here. By default it is in procedural mode and I use this option for spine basically every time. For me to show you what it does, we need to head to animation panel and activate an animation mode. To be able to do that, we first need to have an animation layer, which is this button here. And create an absolute layer. We will get to what all of these buttons do in later episodes, so I am not going to explain everything in detail now. But just so you understand, 3ds Max has two modes, setup mode and animation mode. Switch between with this button here. Until now, in previous episodes, we were doing everything in setup mode, because that is the mode you need to be in when you are doing any changes to the rig. You activate and work in animation mode only after your rig is finished and you are starting to do animations. With that said, let's get back to the spine control setting. In procedural mode, you are not able to manipulate the spine bones and they are locked. The only bones you animate are the hubs, chest and pelvis. And the spine follows and interpolates between them. Spine set like this is sufficient for most of the regular rigs and for spine, I use this setting basically every time. When you switch it to keyframe, it enables you to animate the spine bones individually. However, it comes with some downsides and get unintuitive to animate, because if you manipulate the hub bone, it still affects all the bones in the spine. I have already made a video where I discuss all of this in more detail. That video talks about a lot of things useful for this video also, and you should watch it. So let's switch back to the procedural mode and turn off the animation mode again back to setup mode. Spine curvature graph is something similar we already saw when we talked about twist bones in the last episode. Here it sets how the spine should act when hubs it connects move. You can see that by changing the tangent, I can modify the curvature to be much stiffer next to the pelvis. Or on the other hand, follow the chest much more. You can experiment with this, but I found out that also here, the default values work well for me in most of the cases. Also for spine, you will usually use only two bones anyway, so it doesn't even have that much of an effect. So this is how I would do the spine. But I would also move the chest bone to follow the setup of the spine. For that we will use Edit Poly modifier like we already saw previously. With this modifier we can change the shape of the bone however we like, so I often modify it to be the similar shape as the spine bones are. Collapse the modifier stack when done. This will keep the chest in line with how the spine bones are set, with the pivot point at the bottom. You can also see that the pivot point of chest didn't move at all by changing its shape, which is important. Now for the head, we can add another spine to the chest. One bone will be enough here. And for head, we can again use the same trick as with chest to modify its shape without moving its pivot. However, I must again reference here the video I have mentioned before, because using spine for neck isn't always the best option. In this video I discuss in full detail 4 different versions of how to create a neck, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of these options. It's just 9 minutes long and you should watch it for sure. One last thing to mention when talking about spine is its rotation. If you are creating a quadruped and you would need a horizontal spine instead of a vertical one like humanoids have, don't rotate it like this. To rotate a spine, select one of its bones. Head to motion panel and activate subobject. Now you are able to change the spine direction vector, so rotate it. And when done, disable the subobject mode and rotate the chest. So this should cover all the basics there are to creating a rig in 3ds Max CAD. With these 4 videos, you should be able to create any CAD rig imaginable. However, I recommend to always start with something simple to learn and practice the basics, and only later move to more complicated rigs where you need to think about how to rig some particular parts, because sometimes you need to get creative. Always start with simple things if you are a beginner. So guys, see you in another video. I am Miloš Černý and thank you for watching.